it was a rough start of the season for the number 30 of Jake Weimer behind me. If you remember, he did not even qualify for the main event at Anaheim 1. What you didn't know is the reason behind it. In his crash in that heat race, he ended up tearing the labrum in his shoulder. He went and got a 4.5-inch needle injected. He got an MRI done, and now he said he's riding in more pain than he's ever ridden in. He only got one day of practice in this week. He said he's going to tough up, he's going to man up, and ride through the pain tonight.
Well, let's show you the starting grid of the riders who are going to be in that gate with Jake. And the two that everybody's talking about so far this season, Ryan Dungey, Jason Lawrence. Dungey has one win. They both have two heat race wins. Dungey, the one main event win.
There's no doubt that these riders are the favorite, but Jake Weimer here, seventh in the lineup. He's going to have to grin and bear it and just get through tonight and try to get healed up for next week.
And you talked about at the beginning of the show, some riders have to really step up. You mentioned Billy Leninovich ran very well in his heat, and he's in the main.
And Brent Metcalf in the main event here, he's got something to prove. Andrew McFarland, Chatfield grabbing that final qualifying position.
Dungey and Lawrence, of course, everybody focusing on them. And there you see them right side by side to each other. Here's Dungey, Lawrence right here next to him.
Both these warriors, they're going to battle once again here tonight, and I definitely think that Jason Lawrence has got something for the win, but is Dungey going to be steady and strong as always?
The 32nd board is up. Getting ready for round number two, Dungey versus Lawrence, or maybe it'll be somebody else stepping up to say that they too are going to be a player for the West Coast region title this year. Here we go. Boy, they stack up again in the first corner, and it looks like Dungey gets the better start between the two.
Feel that.
riders so close now as they complete another lap, a third of the way through here in the main. Hepler inside. Nice move to take the lead from Dungey.
No need to wait for that split whoop section. I'm just going to go ahead and take it on this 180.
But that's a great spot for Dungey. He's going to go outside. He likes that. We've seen him take the lead out there already tonight. Here he comes. Oh, he gets the door shut on it. Cuts back to the other side. Back inside, and Dungey retakes it. Great move by this young rider.
This was the part of the track where Hepler was the best. This is where he really closed up on Dungey. Dungey's going to have to remember what happened last time, not make the same mistake going into this 180. Here it comes.
All right, now headed across the start straight. Outside goes Hepler. Dungey tries to counter. Hepler gets him again. We've said that this West Coast series looked like it was going to be one of the best. And boy, is it shaping up that way. That's first, second, third, and fourth all together. Metcalf coming inside now. Here comes Dungey again. Four riders all battling for the lead. Weimer sits in third. Metcalf in fourth. Lawrence has not moved up past sixth yet.
And our top six is completely connected. This is a freight train here in the Lites division. Justin Brayton, off that fantastic ride last week at Anaheim 1, is now in the mix.
Whoa, look at Dungey carrying the speed across. And Hepler cut short on that one, Jeff, and made a big changeup.
That was a great move. That is a line that not many people have used. And what that does is it takes that block pass completely away by just sticking to the inside.
And everybody went inside that time, including Dungey.
Which is so amazing because Dungey made a pass by using the right side of the split. Now everybody has chose to go to the left side.
Oh, a bit of a bobble there for Hepler. Dungey closing in.
Dungey switches it up. He tries the triples, makes a mistake.
Oh, that could have cost him. It definitely cost him time, didn't it?
Now he's looking over his shoulders. He hears all the thunder from these 250Fs behind him.
That's Weimer avoiding Metcalf. Almost took out the rear wheel of Weimer.
Metcalf is really working it. He has something to prove tonight.
And Jason Lawrence, you see him looming in the background on that blue Yamaha. He is inside the top five. Now he's up to fourth. Here comes Dungey. Dungey around the outside of Hepler. Cuts back inside. Side by side, bar to bar over the triple. And it's Dungey taking the lead as the crowd here in Phoenix cheers their approval of this tremendous battle for the lead. Dungey, Hepler, and Weimer one more time with seven to go.
Watch Hepler. Is he going through the inside? No, but Dungey takes a look over his shoulder.
The mechanics cheering their riders on. Lawrence is up to fourth now, Jeff. Oh, boy, Dungey inside. And he slipped big time, and here comes Hepler around him.
Hepler takes advantage of that mistake by Dungey. Will he cut back to the inside? This is that same move as he used before.
Textbook, got the lead right back.
So quick through that turn, he absolutely has that turn dial.
Boy, it is too bad that this is such a short season because these West Coast guys are giving us a tremendous battle and we're just two races in.
Well, it is not short on excitement one bit.
Nothing has changed in the top four as they cross the finish line, but it changed a bunch in between. Now Dungey, that's the biggest lead he's had in a while. And look at Weimer inside of Hepler.
Weimer just flies through the inside, but cannot make the pass stick, and now Lawrence sneaks up the inside.
And he had trouble and then loses a position as Metcalf gets around Lawrence. Dungey, Hepler, Weimer, Metcalf, Lawrence. And joining them is Brayton on the 114, that top six. All still right there.
And just two or three bites behind them is Reardon. He is catching up to this group also.
And Jeff, we heard Jason Lawrence. You see him right there in the 338, the Yamaha, the blue and white rider. He said to win in this series, it's going to take aggressive moves. We've got five to go. two spots. I don't know, did the bike bog down on him? What was that?
He came out of the turn wide. It also created a little bit of problems behind because he didn't jump to triple. Some of the other riders missed it. I see Jason Lawrence off the side of the shot, jumped up to the side onto a tough block.
There you see Jake Weimer out front. Hepler is back going again on the number 60. Dungey now moves up to second. And look at how far back he fell. Hepler is all the way back behind Lawrence now. Dungey chasing after Weimer. Hepler is up to fourth because Lawrence has had problems. He's back behind Reardon now.
This is the battle for the lead, and Jake Weimer has been passed for the lead.
Let's see what happened to Hepler.
This is going across the start-finish line. Hepler chooses that inside line. There is no rut, no traction, and he just loses the bike. He keeps it going, and he's still in the hunt with three to go. Hepler is just off of the lead.
All right, here goes Dungey outside, and look at how Weimer is battling through those whoops, and a slower rider almost gets in the way of Dungey.
What a gift for Weimer there, and
boy, that was so close
right
there.
It is so hard to keep up, but these guys are just battling everything they have. Less than three laps to go to be the winner and be victorious here in Phoenix.
It's gonna take this every week to win this title. And Weimer, early on, Jeff, you said Weimer had such a disappointing run at Anaheim, and he had to step his game up. He's in a position to make a huge statement tonight.
And remember, Jake Weimer is riding with an injured shoulder. He is seriously injured. He is riding with a lot of pain. He is just giving it everything he has. Just an incredible effort by Jake Weimer. Less than two laps to go.
Winning is the best pain medication out there. If he can pull this off, he'll feel great. Weimer, the Saturday night main event winner at the U.S. Open back in October, trying to pull off a big win here in Chase Field. He's got a lap and a half to go.
For Weimer, he just has to keep pushing forward. He cannot worry about what is behind him. He has to ride his lines, make perfect turns, not make any of those little mistakes that will give Dungey that opportunity to stick the front wheel in and to cause any disruption in his forward progress.
They got some slower riders in front of them now.
Dungey goes left split.
Here they come. That shoulder's got to be taking a beating through that whoop section. Slower rider gets out of the way. Weimer cuts him off. Now, Dungey changes up the line, cuts him. Oh, and Weimer comes out with the lead.
Weimer still nails the triple.
Oh, that could be the difference because Weimer has a big gap and a big whip as he makes his way towards the checkers.
One turn to go.
Jake Weimer, here he comes, the winner in Phoenix. Beaten, battered, and bruised, and Jake Weimer's a winner here in Phoenix. We'll be right back to talk to him. Event here at Chase Field, the Supercross Lites West Coast Region, round number two. Here's the results, and Jake Weimer has stepped up. Boy, for a guy who's supposedly in the worst pain he's been in, he was phenomenal in that feature.
That was a great, that was one of the best main events I have ever seen.
Well, a couple of guys did everything they could to keep Jake Weimer off the top step, and they're sitting with Aaron.
What an exciting race. I'll tell you, most people would be pretty satisfied taking home second place, but the look says it all. Ryan, you are disappointed right now.
Yeah, I'm happy, I am, but a little disappointing. You know, just a couple mistakes. I could have had it, but you know, we're in the championship, and that's, I think, the main thing, you know. But it would have been nice to walk away with the win, but seconds, it's right there up there, too. So just want to thank Team Rockstar, Makita Suzuki, Gurney, Oakley, Answer, One Industries, Nike 6.0, and my mom and dad, and for God for keeping me safe. I appreciate it.
Congratulations on taking home second place. But this guy, a phenomenal performance for sure. Last weekend, 19th, and making its way up to the box, Brett Metcalf. Brett, this has got to be a huge confidence booster for you this weekend.
Yeah, for sure. You know, it's last weekend wasn't the start we needed, but able to come back this weekend and get a third, which was really good for my confidence, but also just for the championship. And, you know, I'm happy with third.
Winston in a little bit of pain, regroup. We'll see you again next weekend at Anaheim, too.
Oh, yeah, can't wait.
Neither can we. After the quality of racing we've seen in this class, that is going to be a show that you're definitely going to want to tune in for. We're coming back to talk to Jake Weimer, the big winner, after this.
This Valentine.
Here's the victory podium area, and Jake Weimer soaking it all in. Took him a while to get there. Let's take you back and show you the whole shot replay as this one got underway when the gate dropped.
And this was a battle royale brewing from the very beginning, and you can see Weimer gets that hole shot.
Good look at our progressive hole shot. And of course, it's all a part of our road to Vegas, and Jake Weimer planning on being a big part of it when we get to the season finale in Las Vegas, first weekend in May. Of course, for the Lites guys, that means the East-West shootout. And the first time we get to see the two classes go head-to-head, bar-to-bar, and it's always a thrilling event inside Sam Boyd Stadium. And right now, Ryan Dungey with the points lead in the West by 9 now over Jason Lawrence. Weimer moves up to 6th, and he's standing by with Aaron.
Celebrating his first official Supercross Lites victory. Jake Weimer, after the week that you have had, what is going through your head right now with that victory?
Oh, I'm stoked. I don't even know what to say. You know, it's awesome. Yeah, obviously last weekend I had a bad weekend and I didn't really know how this weekend was going to go. I have a hurt shoulder and I got a good start and just rode a smart race, tried to stay out of trouble, and here I am.
With as competitive as this track was this evening, what was the key to success?
You know, just riding smooth. The track was definitely slick and a little bit tough. The whoops, you know, had a bunch of lines in them, so it was tough. So it was just important to stay smooth and keep your head on straight. And I just want to give a big thanks to Torco Racing Fuels and Evan Knoll. He's a big guy up at Torco, and I know he's not been feeling well, so I wish him to get better. And then also Planet Fitness, they've been huge for us, and I know they're here, so I'm glad that they could be here to experience this with me. So I just want to thank all of them, my trainer, my dad, everybody.
Congratulations on a sweet success.
Thank you.